Welcome to our instructional video for the Pro XM 3D. We'll cover everything you need to know in order to use the unit in your practice. My name is Bernard Fiedler. I'm an X-ray specialist, and I'll guide you through using the unit today. The Pro XM 3D is a hybrid unit that we can use for all 2D, 2D CEF, and 3D imaging. Correct positioning for 2D and 2D CEF imaging is explained in our Pro XM 2D videos. To start imaging with Pro XM 3D, we start by selecting the DVT button in Romexis. ARA allows us to select the level of metal artifact reduction as none, low, medium, or high. This should be selected before imaging. As the 2D positioning aids are currently installed, we need to convert these to 3D. To do this, we remove the temple supports and the entire chin rest apparatus. Now our guide rods are attached to the unit, with the curve projecting inwards, and screwed on so they are hand tight. We simply push our positioning aid for holding the skull in place into the two guide rails. Then we take our 3D chin mount. We can adjust the height of this by turning the small wheel at the back. This regulates the patient's chin height. We use the edentulous chin support for all 3D images. Our patient positioning aid for 3D imaging is now complete. On our display, we go to the 3D button and can now see all the 3D programs available. We have tooth, teeth, double scan, and triple scan. Tooth is our small volume option for 5x5 or 5x8. The 8 corresponds to the height. For teeth, the volumes are 8x8 and 10x8. Our Pro XM 3D also has this as its maximum volume. In this case, it changes to 10x8. Now we'll look at positioning a large volume on our unit, followed by a small volume. We can input the following settings directly via the display. Here we have the volume size, lower jaw, upper jaw, both jaws. Again, there's the option of pre-selecting the patient type and the entry and exit position. Once we've selected our volume or the area that we want to X-ray, we can ask the patient to enter the unit and switch to the positioning level. The C-arm now automatically moves past the patient's head. Now we can enter a number of settings on the display. Select the mu number, switch between volume and scout, and select the ultra-low dose mode and 90-degree positioning, which we will need later for adjustment purposes. Unlike 2D, in 3D we can adjust the patient on the occlusal plane. This controls the upward and downward movement of the unit, and you can switch the laser aimers on and off. Please open your mouth. The lower jaw should always be parallel to the floor. To ensure a clear distinction between the upper and lower jaw in the image, we can place a dental cotton roll between them. Down here, we see the zero line. From here, it goes 8 centimeters upwards. This is the area that we're imaging. Our volume. Now we gently hold the patient in place and use rubber bands to prevent them from wobbling. To adjust the volume laterally, press the 90-degree setting. This moves the C-arm 90 degrees around the patient. We position the canine laser in front of the foremost anterior tooth. Now we have a zero point, from where we go 10 centimeters back. This is essentially our volume depth. Now we press 90 degrees again. To put the unit into imaging mode, we can only trigger imaging when the green light stops flashing and goes a steady green. During this time, we keep our finger on the trigger button. During the scout imaging process, quick side and front images are taken to determine whether the volume is optimally positioned. We can see this in Romexis on our computer. Romexis now shows a simple side image and front image, which allow us to check whether the volume is in an optimal position. If we notice that it isn't properly positioned, we can correct this now. Otherwise, we go to volume and select the volume to another round of imaging. During this time, we keep our finger on the trigger button. You are also free to position the patient in such a way as to keep movement artifacts in the image to a minimum. After the volume is reconstructed, it is automatically saved in Romexis. To position the lower jaw when using ProExam 3D, go to Jaws, then select Lower Jaw. At the same time, I'm setting the volume expansion to 10x8. Now we can switch to the positioning level. When positioning the lower jaw, remember that we're limited to a height of 5 centimeters. This means that we need to position the chin a little higher and spread the jaw with our dental cotton roll. Let's check that we can capture everything in the lower jaw area from the zero point within the 5 centimeters. Now we go to our 90-degree button on the display to adjust the lateral position of the volume. Again, we make sure that our canine laser starts in front of the anterior tooth. The measurement of 10 centimeters backwards also applies here. After that, we can go back to image ready mode by tapping the display. To position the volume in the upper jaw, we go to our display, tap upper jaw, then go to the positioning plane. The display now shows that we have a radiation-free space of 3 centimeters between the zero line and the beginning of the volume. We have to measure this out. We take a cotton roll, position it between the upper and lower jaw, and hold our measuring tape against it. In this case, we have to position the chin a bit lower and adjust the unit accordingly. Our volume area is now between 3 centimeters and 8 centimeters. If this works for us, we go to the 90 degrees section on our display. And place our canine laser in front of the anterior tooth again. Now we can put the unit into image ready mode and start the volume. In order to select the 5x5 volume size, the small volume, we go to tooth and choose from different positioning options. We can choose between middle ear, temporomandibular joint, ramus molar, premolar, canine, and incisor. We can change the setting by tapping on the display. We also have the option of choosing between the upper jaw, lower jaw, or both jaws. Now we switch to the positioning level. The special thing about this is that we can run our volume at 75 mu, that is, in endo mode. This is the highest possible resolution. Again, we start by positioning the dental cotton roll to spread the jaw. Place our tape measure on the zero line and go up 5 centimeters from there. After that, we tap the 90-degree button on our display to adjust the volume laterally. Again, we place the canine laser in front of the anterior region. Now we can go into image-ready mode and start the volume. Let's position the 5x5 volume in the posterior upper jaw, as there are a few things to watch out for here. We start by selecting the upper jaw, going to the premolar area, and then to the positioning level. Again, we use our dental cotton roll as an aid. As this is the upper jaw, we measure out our 3 centimeter radiation-free area. And now we can see that we have 2 laser aimers positioned frontally, one on the mid-sagittal plane, and one at the front at mid-volume. We can now use the joystick to move the laser left and right so that we have the tooth frontally in focus. We then tap on 90 degrees on the display. And set the lateral position of the volume. We now position the laser on the tooth that we want to have in focus next. We do this by moving the joystick left and right until we reach our tooth. Now we get the volume ready for imaging. We can perform temporomandibular joint imaging with the PRO-XM 3D with both small and large volumes. Right, now we'll demonstrate it with the small volume. To do this, we go to the temporomandibular joint section on the display, set the upper jaw positioning, and go to the patient positioning level. Here too, we can use the joystick to target the laser aimer at the temporomandibular joints. Make sure that we still have our 3 cm radiation-free area. Go to the 90 degrees section to aim at the temporomandibular joint from the side too. We use our joystick again for this. Once we have successfully targeted the temporomandibular joint, we can go into image ready mode on the display and start the volume. In order to start teleradiographic imaging on our PRO-XM 3D or 3DQ units, we press teleradiography on our display, remove the chin rest, and fold down the temple supports. Our drop-down menu contains more imaging options. We could select a partially lateral image, for instance. If we don't need this, we can simply switch to the patient positioning level and start positioning the patient. Now we can call the patient into the X-ray room and position them in the unit. We use the toggle switch to move the equipment up and down and adjust the ear tips to the correct height. To move them, we press the silver toggle switch and insert them into the ear canal. Now we can set the Frankfurt horizontal and position the nasion at the bridge of the nose. Once we position the patient, we go to the image ready mode on the display, leave the X-ray room, ask the patient to keep still, and trigger the imaging. Thank you. The entire frame can be rotated for further antero-posterior, postero-anterior positioning. Oblique imaging is also possible. The position remains the same. You can find other types of positioning in our instructions for use. To create a handheld image with the Ceph unit, we first disassemble the headrest and nasion. And attach the hand carpus plate. After that, we rotate the frame in the hand carpus plate. We now select hand on the display and go to the positioning level. Now we can position the patient's hand on the hand carpus plate, go into image ready mode, and perform the imaging. Further details of the CAVO PRO-XM 3D and Romexis are available on the CAVO website, in the other videos, and in the instructions for use. Thanks for watching.